Hey everyone, it's Duncan Epping, yellowbricks.com, and today I want to show you something that was introduced as part of vSAN 7.0 Update 1, and that is the shared witness appliance for two-node configurations. So what I'm going to do in this demo is I'm going to create a two-node cluster, and that two-node cluster is going to use a witness appliance. Now, for those who don't know, that witness appliance is basically used as a quorum mechanism, which allows vSAN to determine who owns the data when a particular failure scenario has occurred. So we've just created a cluster, and of course, after the cluster has been created, what we are going to do is we're going to create another cluster. And that second cluster is going to use the exact same witness appliance as the first cluster is using. Now, of course, for those who haven't seen it or used it before, traditionally, what you would need to do in this scenario is deploy a second witness appliance. But in this case, I can simply reuse the existing witness appliance and just share it between the two clusters. So I'm going to create a new cluster. As you can see, this cluster creation actually uses the quick start wizard where the previous didn't. So you see both ways of actually enabling vSAN. I'm going to select the hosts, which are part of my two-node configuration. And after I've done that, of course, I will need to enable some of the services for vSAN specifically as well. Now, I completed this part of the wizard. The second part is the configuration of the cluster, and at the configuration of the cluster section, I can select the two-node configuration. I can create a normal cluster, I can create a stretch cluster, or I can create a two-node configuration. In this case, I'm going to create a two-node configuration specifically as we're looking at the shared witness capability. So let's go ahead and select two-node vSAN cluster. And then after we've selected two-node vSAN cluster, we can select the witness host. Now, as mentioned previously, you will need to deploy a new witness appliance, but now we can actually use the exact same witness appliance as we've selected for the previous cluster as well. Our witness appliance is .122. So we're going to go ahead, create the cluster, and then after the cluster has been created, what we're going to do is we're going to look at virtual machines which are deployed in both clusters and simply look at the witness components that are part of those virtual machines to figure out if they are actually stored on the same witness appliance. So let's just wait a couple of seconds for the configuration to finish, and then after it has been configured, as I mentioned, we're going to go ahead and look at those virtual machines that are deployed. In my first cluster, I already deployed a virtual machine called SW2. When we click on the virtual machine and we go to physical disk placement in the monitoring section, we can immediately see that it's already has a couple of objects deployed, and those objects, of course, have a witness. The witness is stored in the host called 122. Now, for my second cluster, I still need to deploy a virtual machine. And of course, after I have deployed my virtual machines, I'm just using the default profile, default storage policy here. And after I've deployed my virtual machine, I can go ahead and look at my objects again. Of course, my witness appliance or my witness component for this virtual machine should again be stored in 122. So let's click the VM. Let's look at physical disk placement. And there you go. We're using the exact same witness appliance. So hopefully with that, I've been able to show you the strength of vSAN and the strength of a shared witness appliance. Thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel.